Sarah Taylor. And the way she kept was brilliant.
From England's point of view, I think they'll be hoping that that rubs off on her batting. Certainly has been under pressure.
Perry and Seymour. Worked away into the leg side. Push hard for two. Nicely driven. They're going to push hard for a single. Short and wide, and it's cut away nicely.
A test for Megan Schutt here.
Full toss. White got enough of it.
That responsibility does play on her mind.
Given away nicely through the covers, possibly two. Worked away, a nice shot. And on the drive, but on the leg side, as it's going to just get to the boundary, and his mid on is pretty straight. She works it away down the slope, down the hill.
Who can bowl throughout the innings.
Don't lend her any. It looked like she was trying to work the ball into square leg. She's got a lot straighter than that. This time it's up the hill, though. Rather than race away down the hill for four, they come back for three.
All forms of the game being used.
Beautiful timing again from Sarah Taylor. But I think it's very clear for everybody to see that she has got an abundance of talent. It was somewhat of a mystery. No sign of an injury, a bit of a miscalculation perhaps with the overs on Jodie Fields' part.
Well, a short delivery first up. Good shot, late cut, and it's quick this outfield. Good end to the 10th over. 64-1, England. So 8 runs come from that over.
I think definitely. And I think that's something that the coaching staff talk to the players about a lot.
England move on to 64. And I like this. What I like about this is the fact they're building. They're not worried about the boundary, it's about just keep ticking over the scoreboard.
Australia 52 for 170.
Up and over. That's a lovely shot, that controlled over the top of mid off. And once again, excellent timing from Sarah Taylor. Well, that was a full banger, not quite capitalised on. Straight to the fielder, but still a pretty good over that for England. It's away to the leg side, just single this time.
A little bit soft.
So who are the favourites from here then? Whose camp would you rather be in?
Don't take a risk. As England are so far ahead of the game almost that they're...
Spinner Erin Osborne back into the attack.
Just holds this one back, but because she's been aggressive and looking to use her feet, she'll have to just play on the crease and work it into square leg for one.
Got a great start, but just the single. Nice little dab. It's That'll be a couple. And good running
gap for a two.
It's up and over. And just the single this time.
He gives some pull shot. Going on with it a bit more. Australia just can't starve her of the single. Yeah, and from a good over from Osborne, the off spin in the over before, perfectly so far.
Just the three boundaries as well, so that emphasises just how well. Pushing for two. And that's going to go upstairs.
Direct hit, and you also think if she'd have just been in front of the stumps, taken the ball in front of the stumps, rather than the ball having to go past the stumps, take the ball, if she'd actually have gone in front of the stumps, you think she probably would have been gone as well. But as it is, she's going to be in, which is brilliant from England's point of view. Number two.
Could be two more here. Oh, just wide of the fielder there from Sarah Taylor, using her feet again. And another fumble.
Not good. Not good start after the drinks break. Help me. Help on its way, rather. For Sarah Taylor, 56 now from 50.
Needing to keep anchoring this innings. Not necessarily changing how she plays, but just getting a partnership back underway.
Two more. Maybe that's why Elise Perry's into the attack. Very similar to why Catherine Brunt was brought into the attack at that very same time. In your best ball. A decent catch, but it'll go for nothing, of course. Oh, and Leicester, oh, well. A little bit of chaos at the end there, it needed a dive. In the end, the ball wasn't gathered by Jodie Fields. Heaved away. Outfield is quick enough.
Well dispatched by Sarah Taylor. She plays that front foot pull that she plays so well and dissects long on and deep mid-wicket perfectly.
Oh, would you believe it? Dragged on, I think. Very innocuous ball outside the off stump, and it's exactly what we were talking about. England have lost two now in the middle.